Hi again everyone, Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation I'm going to continue my series of videos on complex numbers. Now in previous videos we talked about complex polynomials and the factor theorem and we did some examples. In this video I'm going to continue in that vein and I'm going to do another example using factorization. Okay, so let me share my screen with you and we can get down to business. Okay, so this is the example we're going to look at. I've got a polynomial of degree 7 defined to be z to the 7 plus 3 to the 7. And we're asked to find the roots of that polynomial just by solving this equation here and hence factorize p of z into linear factors. Now, let's just review the very basic theory of complex polynomials of degree n. So you've got some sort of polynomial. In this case, the degree n would be 7, the degree 7. There are four essential main points. Every polynomial of degree n has at least one root in the set of complex numbers. This is a very deep idea called the fundamental theorem of algebra. If the roots, if the coefficients of the polynomial are real, as we have here, then the roots appear in conjugate pairs. And if alpha is a root of the polynomial, then z minus alpha is a factor of p of z. And every polynomial of degree n can be factored into n linear parts, where the alpha sub i's are the roots, and the a sub n comes from the coefficient of z n. So this is like a factor theorem, if you like, here. Okay, so with that in mind, let's have a look at the following example. Let's work through it. Okay, so we have the following. Let's consider this equation. We'll solve it. And then by the factor theorem, I can write P of Z as this sort of combination of linear factors where the alpha i's are the roots. Okay, so what we're going to do is think of this slightly rearranged equation. And I'm going to write the right-hand side in a polar exponential form. Okay, now this is a z and this is a 3. I know they look alike. I put little tails on my z, but that's just the way I write it. So this, if I sort of draw a little rough sketch in the complex plane, negative 3 to the 7 will lie on the real axis and it will lie, say over here. Okay, so it's 3 to the 7 units away from the origin, and to get over there you do a half revolution. So in terms of polar exponential forms, you've got a length times e to the angle times I. So here it's half a turn, so it would be pi I. And these sort of representations are not unique. So what we're going to do, you can keep spinning around and around by one revolution to get back to the same point. So I can introduce a 2k pi up here. In the following way. Okay, now this is, having this here is designed to catch all the solutions to this problem. If you just tried to rearrange this, you would get one solution. Whereas having the 2k pi I, don't forget the I up there, ensures that you have you catch all the solutions. Okay, so this is a bit of groundwork here, but let's use this. Take the 7 to the other side and use our index laws. And we'll get something like the following. You'll get a 1/7 there, so the 3 to the 7 will just become 3. And then you can use your index laws to, or exponent laws to come up with the following. All right. So what I'm going to do now is put in basic values of k, and I'll get out a solution for each value of k. Okay, now I'm looking for 7 solutions here. So I'm going to introduce a subscript. Z sub 0 is going to represent the solution for k equals 0. And I'll put in k equals 1, k equals 2, etc. So k equals 0 just gives me the following. What about if I subbed in another value for k, say k equals 1. So I'll get 3 in this bracket. So this would be another solution. What about if I subbed in, say, k equals 2? I'll get 5 in this bracket. What happens if I subbed in, say, k equals 3? I'll get 7 in this bracket. That's going to cancel off with that 7. So I'll get 3e to the pi I. Now, pi I is just over here, so this will be negative 3. Okay, now hopefully you can see a bit of a pattern here. The solutions all have the same sort of coefficient in the polar exponential form, and they differ by the same amount, 2 pi on 7 from here to here, 2 pi on 7 from here to here, 2 pi on 7 from here to here. Okay, now because the coefficients in this problem are real, that's pretty much all we have to calculate, because we know the conjugate of this will be a solution, the conjugate of this will be a solution, and the conjugate of this will be a solution. So we know, that, and we've already got that, so that'll be my 7 solutions. Okay, so I don't really have to do any more calculations. You can if you want. If you put in, say, k equals negative 1, you can go through and grind it out if you want to. But you know that they're the conjugate of each other, same with those ones, and you know that they're going to be solutions as well. Okay, so there's my solutions here. Okay, they appear in conjugate pairs, and it turns out you've got one real valued solution as well. Okay, so we've solved P of Z. Now, if you were to plot these on in the complex plane, you would draw a little circle, centered at the origin, radius 3, and you would mark all of these on that circle. Okay. All right. So by the factor theorem. We know that the polynomial can be written as a product of linear factors like this, where a sub n is the coefficient of z to the n here, n 7 and a to the n, a sub n would be 1, and the alpha sub i's are all roots. Okay, so all we need to do is write it in the following form. Probably going to run out of room here. So I'm going to write them together in the with the conjugates. Okay, this one and this one. Oop, 3. Okay, so I'm going to continue on down here. Actually, let's continue on over here. So, that and that. Okay, just squeezing it all in. And lastly, the real part. So that'll be z minus negative 3, z plus 3. Whew, okay, so big long mess, but that is this polynomial, that polynomial factored into linear factors. Now, here's something for you to do. Show that P of Z can also be factored into real linear factors and irreducible quadratic factors. Okay, I'll show you what I mean by that, just by writing it down. Okay, here's our real linear factor. Let's see if I can squish this in down here. Yes. Okay, so here's something for you to do. Show that P of Z, this form, can also be written in this place, where these three brackets contain quadratic factors that don't factorize over the real numbers. Okay, so this is like irreducible, and irreducible quadratic factors. Okay, and you've got a linear factor too with a real part. Okay, so that's something for you to do. Now, to do that, all you really would do would be expand this bracket, combine these brackets. Okay, so I'll leave that for you to do. Okay, well, that's my example. Hope you enjoyed it. I hope you are finding these videos on complex numbers useful. We're going to do another example in the next video, a similar problem using factorization. Hope you can join me for that presentation. If you have any comments, any questions, any suggestions, I'd love to hear them. So you can always put a comment in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, and please join me for my next video on complex numbers. Bye.